bloodline and pedigree. He did not. All this is the scored the winning goal in overtime. Bondra assisted on it. So those two guys on one of five lines here. This is a Smyrna Heart team with a lot of players on the team. They go five lines deep. They go with one goalie in Danko, who has been there all season long. And I mentioned that not only has he been great all year, but he has been excellent as of late for this team.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, good evening and welcome to the Carmen Sonny's House for the 2013 Maryland Student Hockey League 1A Championship game. Before we have our warm-up session for the teams, we ask that you please direct your attention down to the area in front of the penalty box for the presentation of the Ivan LeBray Award. Here to present the award, please welcome Joe LaCour.
Joe LaCour down on the ice.
Thank you, Derek.
We will be making the presentation of the
each year,
which is a
the Gardens Ice Coast,
and this is something that recognizes just one
each year, the Gardens Ice Coast, the
Maryland Student Hockey League,
present an annual award to the senior who best exemplifies play on the ice.
On the ice.
Diligence in the classroom.
But also the way that he performs in the
and
classroom.
Community service.
And the way that he is a member of his community. Is he a good citizen? And Sean Krebs is the guy who wins
this year. This year it is our great honor to present it to
of Washington.
Number 59 of Washington County, Sean Krebs.
Center. Kyle Omar backhands it back into the Severna Park end, and again played back out the center, right back onto the stick of Omar. Omar off the boards near side, where Travis Biggs gets tied up with Jake Seifert, and Seifert able to force it back into the Washington County end, where Jeremy Benda leaves it behind the net for Omar. Omar got tied up for a moment by Ryan Fry, the leading goal scorer this season for Severna Park. Fry pinching in the corner. Puck comes loose to Krebs. Krebs helps it around to the far side to Zach Elmahandas. Elmahandas leaves it for Krebs. Krebs tried to play it to the blue line to Biggs, but it was broken up there by Seifert, and Seifert sends it right back into the Washington County end. Now Omar tries to get it out, stolen at the blue line by Nick Bondrine, put in front, and that one is sent to the corner. Boy, that was an anxious moment there. Bondra coming up with a steal just inside the blue line. He played just over a minute of the opening period. Drew Brooks tries to fire it in, but that one got caught up in the skates of a Severna Park player and only made it about halfway into the zone, and there it's picked up by Ryan Fry. Fry knocked off the skates on a nice play by Travis Biggs. Now Arizona Service moves in front, shot, and a goal! That was Danko able to make the save, got a couple of swipes at it inside. Service, Biggs, and Barron, all with opportunities.
Yeah. They set up a nice little play for the defense. Danko was able to get him out of it. At least the short side of the shoulder could get to him and get pressure on him.
Face off will come to the right of the Severna Park netminder. And it winds up in a stalemate, finally forced out to the blue line and out. Chris Zacharias sends it right back in, delayed offside against the North Stars. They'll have to let the Falcons go play it. And it is Jake Seibel who gets dumped, and that will be a penalty coming up against Washington County. And this could potentially be a 2-10 for a checking from behind. We'll have to wait for the call. Only a boarding call.
Only a boarding. That was a check from behind. That was not a smart play, but here we go, Wes. Talked about the pregame. We're going to have to kill a penalty here in the first 2 minutes of this game.
Well, deja vu from Wednesday night. North Stars committed an early penalty, and that was kind of the thing that got them started, killing a penalty early on Wednesday night against Carroll County. Arizona Service to the box. Now Nick Bondra works in against Di Mercurio. Backhanded shot stopped by Benda, and then the net becomes dislodged as Severna Park crashes it. Jeremy Benda made the save. He wasn't quite sure where the puck was, and then once he knew where it was, Severna Park kept coming because there was no whistle. Puck was under his right pad, and we get a stoppage with the net replaced with 11 seconds gone in the penalty kill. Faceoff will come to the right of Jeremy Benda this first period, brought to you by the Hagerstown Ice and Sports Complex. And it's the Hagerstown Ice and Sports Complex penalty kill here for Washington County, and hoping for a successful one as Finn Code plays it to the far side boards for Severna Park. Gets trapped there by Omaha. Severna Park long to cash in on that power play. The North Stars just unable to account for everybody, down a man. Code did a good job of being very patient with the puck down low with nobody marking him, and was able to get it to Bondra in front. Now Bondra again, high slot, backhanded pass intended for the leading scorer, Fry. Broken up, fortunately for the North Stars, by Sean Krebs. Krebs carries all the way back in. Krebs all the way to the high slot. And finally, the puck dislodged from a stick by Jonathan Seibel. North Stars keep it in. Elmahandas from the left point. The shot goes wide, deflects to the near side boards, and it's swept out of the zone back to center, right back in, and picked up by Severna Park's Seibel. Seibel plays it down in the Washington County end. Omar comes up with it, deflected by St. Lawrence out to center, and Brooks comes together with Jake Seibel. Puck comes to the near side boards, and finally back into the Severna Park end.
And now it's Travis Biggs who hops through it for the North Stars, but he's outnumbered. Right now, 2-on-4. Biggs behind the net, plays it around to the point on the far side, but nobody home. Omar backtracks to get it, dumps it back into the Severna Park end. Seibel goes down low to get it below the goal line. Barron goes to the ice after applying the hit. Far side now, played over to Zervis. And Severna Park able to gain possession and send it the length into the Washington County end. Di Mercurio behind the net, picks it up. Michael carries it out, had it deflected off his stick momentarily. Gets it again, plays it to center, and it's stolen away by Severna Park. And played back in deep by Jesse Kuhlman. Kuhlman plays it around, now gets it back behind the net. Boy, had a chance to set something up, but Travis Biggs able to get there and break it up. Plays it past Omar, around to the far side to Zervis. Zervis gets it out of the zone. Biggs at center, plays it ahead to himself, has one man to beat. Biggs all the way and scores! Seconds to answer the Severna Park goal, and Travis Biggs says, so much for making me honorable mention. I'll go right over the shoulder of an All-State goalie to tie this game up at one. Biggs with a beautiful goal.
Assisted by number 69, Arizona
Zervis picks up an assist on the goal. And right in front, Benda makes one save, and then finally his defense comes to the rescue as Drew Brooks gets it out of the zone back to center. A near break for Nate Lightning, but instead it's taken away on the steal by Fry. Fry plays it off the boards back out to center. Now the pass behind Sean Kreps. Kreps tried to play it back to his own man, but it's stolen by Fry. Fry to the blue line. He's got Bondra with him. Bondra in below the goal line, played it back in front. Benda knocks it down, but it's still loose side of the net. In front, Bondra, backhander broken up. Back out to the blue line. Shot by Seifert goes wide. Cracked down by Brooks. Brooks to the far side, and a good play by Kreps to play it off the boards to himself, but an even better play by Bondra stepping in defensively to slow down the progress. Now back comes Finn Code, who got an assist on the Bondra goal. He fires one wide from beyond the blue line. He's headed to the bench on a line change. The North Stars try to take advantage, but Zervis shoveled it too far ahead. Nobody to hand it to. Back into the Washington County end, off the stick of Max Code. A lot of brothers on this team for the Severna Park team. I believe they have four sets of brothers on this team. Jesse Kuhlman with the steal started back the other way out of the Severna Park end, had it broken up, and now onto the stick of Finn Code. Code got it all the way back to the blue line of the North Stars, but broke it up again. Now here comes Travis Biggs. Biggs back into the Severna Park end, all the way to the front of the net, and finally relieved of the puck by Jonathan Seibel. Biggs, who had a great rush earlier to tie this game with another head of steam there, and finally had the puck taken off his stick. Backhanded pass from behind the net in front by Josh Barron broken up. And now Severna Park will alleviate the pressure by at least getting it out to the safety of neutral ice. But the North Stars turn it right back with Zervis, broken up at the blue line, and Barron couldn't get it either. Tom Shelton made the defensive play for Severna Park back in the Washington County defensive end. Severna Park, who scored 2 minutes and 2 seconds into this game, really hasn't applied a ton of pressure since. They had one real good scoring opportunity, but Jeremy Bender was able to make the play out, and then his defense was able to clear it. North Stars have really picked up the intensity since tying this game. Elmer Hondas does a good job defensively, even though he was the one who went to the ice and throwing his shoulder into the puck carrier. Puck coming loose, and now the North Stars gain possession. Morgan Kenworthy trying to get out of the Washington County end, but the puck kept in the North Stars side. Finally out as Kenworthy gets it to center. Kenworthy shoulder to shoulder against Joe Wheaton, and the puck winds up squirting back into the Washington County end, and this will be an icing call against Severna Park. Wow, real frenetic pace. It's really picked up since each team scored.
Physically speeding. This is everything you expect in a championship game.
Two hockey teams who seemingly have a lot of talent, have a lot of hockey IQ. up and down the ice, off the faceoff, back to the point, and oh, boy, that's a blast from the blue line by Josh Barron, and that went over everything. Now DiMercurio from just inside the blue line. Wrist shot through, Danko saves it, sends it to the far side where Bailey Pottinger gets to it for Severna Park, and out to center, and Josh Barron sends it right back in deep. Jake Seifert there for Severna Park. Leaves it for his teammate, who plays it back out to neutral ice. Michael DiMercurio says that's far enough and gets it back to Josh Barron. Barron down the right wing. Plays it around Eric Manning and down deep where Bailey Pottinger gets to it first. He and Zervis tie it up. Now pinching in, DiMercurio gets it in front, and Zervis just did send it wide of the left post. That's the glove hand side of Danko. Now Barron shoulder to shoulder with Pottinger in the corner, and a chance of block. So again, able to steer it away. North Stars with a couple of good opportunities to put the puck behind him, but Danko equal to the task on each chance. Now the North Stars at neutral ice. Josh Barron picks up the loose puck. He enters the Severna Park zone, lost it between the skates of Jonathan Seibel. Seibel couldn't get it out. Drew Brooks with the steal. Brooks' feet in front, broken up by Jake Seifert, and the Falcons able to get it out to neutral, but right back in below the net. Finn Code now near the red line for Severna Park, marked by Brooks. Ahead now to Fly, and Fly is dumped by Omar. Severna Park faithful calling for a penalty, but no arm in the air. Referees say play on.
We got away with one there, Wes.
Lifty across to Kreps. Kreps tripped up by Fly. No call there, and now a breakout potential for Fly, but he couldn't track down the puck. It got behind him, and he had to spin around and couldn't get possession of it. Severna Park able to dump it back into the Washington County end. Kyle Omar feeds it out to Leifke. And Leifke takes a big shoulder and then takes a seat on the ice as Code rammed into him. And now Omar with a big hit on the far side on Sheldon, sending him sprawling to the ice. North Stars force it back into the Severna Park end. And Sheldon, who had just absorbed that hit, trying to play it out, but it's deflected up and out of play by Nate Leifke. 5:27 to play in the first period, and we'll get a timeout. Back to live action in the 1A state championship hockey game. North Stars and Severna Park Falcons tied at one. And play resuming with five from outside the blue line. And Josh Barron able to win it, and he lifts it all the way in behind the net. Arizona's Zervis putting on the pressure on Jake Seibel. Seibel lost his edge. Zervis and Seibel battle for it, and Severna Park able to come away with it. DiMercurio keeps it in at the blue line, but could not maintain possession. And it's Seibel who starts it back the other way, ahead to Kuhlman. Kuhlman fires it wide of the glove hand of Benda, and then an interesting bounce off the boards from behind the net. Nearly came right back in front, but the North Stars able to get to it. Zacharias kept any harm from happening. And now here comes Josh Barron up the right wing. Plays it around Wheaton. And Barron goes into the corner now and battles there with Jake Seibel. Barron comes away with it out in front, and a shot by DiMercurio, who skated onto it. That one blocked down in front. Behind the net, Biggs plays it around to the far side, but nobody home there. And emerging with it, Joe Wheaton for Severna Park. Got it back to as far as the Washington County blue line, but Zacharias turned it back the other way. Now right off the bench, here comes big Ryan Fry, and Fry went through a couple of players like they were obstacles on an obstacle course, and then finally Michael DiMercurio able to pull for the puck from him. Both teams really at a stalemate right now, just going back and forth. And now Drew Brooks hauled down by Fry, no call. Both players go to the ice. Now Brooks back down after he had gotten back to his skates. Elmahandas plays it back into the Severna Park end. That was a delayed offside. And now here comes Bondra. Bondra with a shot and a great save by Benda. Wow. He was backing up on that one, and Bondra let that one rip, and a great glove save.
Yeah. I'll tell you, Bondra's got a heck of a wrist shot, but that was a great glove save. Woo, man.
So Jeremy Benda makes a huge save here with 3:44 to go to keep this game even. 1-1 off the faceoff, Bondra with the shot and off the blocker of Benda, and it deflects to the far side. And quickly there is Finn Code for Severna Park, but He was unable to wrest it away from Zach Elmahondas, who plays it out to center. Now Pottinger turns it right back into the Washington County end. Elmahondas again there to play it, gets it out to Drew Brooks, and Brooks gets bent on a big hit just inside the red line. And we've got a penalty coming up on the North Stars.
I saw it the other way.
Man, oh man, Drew Brooks had the puck. This is going to be a head contact penalty against Washington County, and it will be on Drew Brooks. And that's a tough call, Mark. I mean, he had the puck, didn't he?
I hate to say it, I saw that penalty going the other way. I thought it was enough. Actually, I was watching Jeremy at net because he started coming out thinking the penalty was on them, as you saw. Well, this is the second time now in the first period we were not successful in the first penalty goal. We're going to have to kill this one off.
So Severna Park gets the man advantage with 3:11 to play in this first period. And the North Stars penalty killers will go to work. Hagerstown Ice Sports Complex penalty kill, hoping for more success than the first time around. Ryan Fry plays it across far side, broken up then by Elmahondas. And that has him limping a little bit, might have hit him right on the toe. Now a shot fired wide by Jake Seifert, deflects to the far side. Bailey Pottinger gets there, dumped by Barron, but he was able to get the puck down low. And now Barron with another big hit. Pottinger goes down again. But Severna Park again with an opportunity, and Barron makes the save on a shot from the top of the faceoff circle to his left by Finn Code with 2:34 to play in the first period. 1:22 remaining on the Severna Park penalty. Are on the power play, and North Stars penalty kill. Faceoff coming to the left of Benda. Barron and Fry on the draw, and it's won by the North Stars, and DeMercurio able to send it all the way down to where Danko comes out to play it, and he will leave it for Seifert. Severna Park will wind it up with Fry to the red line, has Code with him, dumps it in deep. Bondra goes to chase it, but it's DeMercurio who's there first, gets it to the point, and now played by Zervis. Zervis with Pottinger on him. Zervis to the front of the net for Pottinger. Takes him off the stage and knocks the stick out of Arizona's hands. Never able to get a shot on net, but still, Zervis with a terrific play on the penalty kill to almost get a little offense going here. And again, the steal by Zervis. And again, he takes the big hit. And now Krebs comes back. And Krebs with a big hit. And meantime, at the other end, Code with a shot. Saved by Benda. Omar emerges with the puck. Skates by one man. It's a one-on-two. Omar goes to the far side. Omar in front. Oh, broken up by Code. Never got through to Danko. Now Travis Biggs will reset. North Stars look to kill off the penalty down to 5 seconds remaining on it. And the teams are back to even strength with 1:11 to go in the opening period. And neither team shying away from physical play here in this first period.
Now, clearly the referees are
left.
They're doing what they're supposed to do.
1 minute remaining in the first period. 1 minute.
But like I was saying, was, you know, you don't want to see the referees calling all these little tick-tack penalties. So,
they are getting after it. We talked about the North Stars' aggressiveness against Carroll County last week, and they certainly have not turned it down any. And Severna Park, a very physical team. They're a team with a lot of size, too, really matching up against the North Stars here. And neither team backing down, and we've got an even hockey game so far, 1-1 in the final 45 seconds of this opening period. North Stars in their own end, play it out to the blue line, and it's Travis Biggs. Biggs into the Severna Park end, around Weed, and he fires high, or rather around Sheldon, and he fires high to the far side. DeMercurio had a chance to pitchfork it back in, but the puck bounced off his stick, and the North Stars will have to go chase as the Falcons send it back into the Washington County end. Barron leaves it for DeMercurio. Now ahead to Krebs. Krebs with Barron waiting on the opposite side. Krebs down the right wing. Had it knocked away by Sheldon. Goes to get it back behind the net and broken up by Pottinger. Pottinger plays it around. Not out though. DeMercurio keeps it in. Down to 3 seconds remaining in the period. And Krebs and Sheldon come together as the first 15 minutes expire. Wow.
A great first period here between the two best teams in Class 1A and representing well. At the end of one, Severna Park 1, Washington County 1. Back with more in just a moment.
County 6 for Severna Park 5.
Back to the Gardens Ice House in Laurel at the end of the first period in the Class 1A state championship hockey game. Severna Park won Washington County. Severna Park got on the board first, 2 minutes and 2 seconds in. On the power play, Nick Bondra from Finn Code, a 1-0 lead, but the North Stars answered 1 minute, 11 seconds later. Travis Biggs with a great individual effort on a goal assisted by Arizona Zervis to tie it at one, and that's where we stand. Not a whole lot of shots in that first period, only 11 total shots, 6 for Washington County, 5 for Severna Park, but that certainly belies all the action we saw, Mark.
Oh, a lot of action, but all 11 of those shots were pretty good scoring opportunities for both teams. Both goaltenders had to come up big and keep their team in this first period.
And that's one thing we did expect, the goalies to be called on often in this game, and the goal is to respond. Two excellent netminders, possibly the two best in the entire state, head-to-head here in Jeremy Bender for the North Stars and Travis Danko for Severna Park. North Stars trying to apply some pressure, and Travis Biggs nearly able to set himself up after gloving the puck down. It's stolen away by Jesse Kuhlman, and then back out to center where the North Stars go to try to regain possession, and Arizona Zervis forces it back in to the Severna Park end. Played out to center, but Kyle Omar gets it for Washington County. Going to try to reset the offense here, but Zervis couldn't get his stick on the bouncing puck enough to settle it down and really set his team up. So instead, North Stars will opt for a line change here. And again, Severna Park, a team that goes very deep on their lines. They have got five full lines, and seemingly from what we've seen so far in this game, they have a lot of guys who can really play this game well. There isn't a lot of drop-off in talent when they switch lines. When they go from line one to line two, or from line two to line three, or you know, so on and so forth, all of their lines seem to be pretty talented. They all have high hockey IQs, and certainly just about every single player out there has no qualms with being a physical hockey player. And we have seen lots of physicality in this game so far, all very legal for both teams. We've had two penalties go against the North Stars so far in this game. And Severna Park able to score on one of them. Now Nick Bondra with a steal. Di Mercurio able to get back, and Bondra tried to feather it through once Di Mercurio got back on him for Ryan Fry, but it was broken up. Back the other way. Oh, the puck just did elude Drew Brooks, who had it for a moment, but the defense of Joe Wheaton forced him to give it up. Now Bondra with Fry with him again. Fry lost it off his skate, and Zacharias plays it back off the boards at center. And Wheaton will go back to chase for Severna Park. Plays it around to the near side. Code backhands it past Krebs and over to Fry, and now to Bondra. Bondra for Fry. Fry down the middle, broken up by the skates of Biggs, and back out across the blue line as the North Stars clear the zone. Now Lifty didn't see that one go by him. Fortunately, Krebs picks it up, and he is hit by Jake Seibel, and a shot that Danko has to make a save on. That one came out of nowhere. Danko saw it all the way, though. It was kind of a harmless shot. Just got the big paddle of his stick on. No problem there. And now as Di Mercurio turns, he lifts the puck up and over the Washington County bench and out of play. And we get a stop. Much better team when leading at the end of the first period. Only 4-3 this year when tied or trailing at the end of the first period. But again, this game like no other. This is for the state championship. Off the faceoff, Severna Park controls, but they don't get it far, not even to the red line, before Zervis turned it back the other way.
Now it's El Mahandas. He gets it through to Barron, who was waiting at the blue line. Knocked down, not once, but twice.
Well, they're not calling anything, are they, Wes?
No, you really have to do a good job.
You might as well trip them, because they're definitely not calling tripping.
Yeah, you have to do a good job of maintaining your balance first and foremost in this game, but it's tough when you're treated like a pinball out there, and that's been the case. And both teams have been able to exert themselves again. Talked about the physicality. Biggs with a big hip check a moment ago, able to get the puck free to Barron, who shoots at Danko. Makes a great save with the glove. Almost made, as some of you might recall, the way Ricky Henderson used to catch some of those fly balls out there with his glove. And now, at the other end, Bender comes back and makes a save, and we get a stoppage with 11:54 to go. So the goalies showcase there end-to-end. And a hockey game all tied at one. Bondra for Severna Park and Biggs for Washington County. Deadlocked at one with 11:54 to play in this middle period. Mentioned it earlier, but coming into this game, Danko has been nearly impenetrable of late for the Severna Park team. They've only given up two goals in the two playoff games. Has three shutouts on the season, won't get one here tonight. And the North Stars again trying to apply the pressure, but can't get far enough into the zone to get a good-looking shot off. Now back the other way, Seibel trying to get something started in front, and Bender covers it up, and they're still poking away at it. And now we'll get a little physicality beyond the realm of, I believe, what the officials are going to stand for. And it was all started by Brung Behringer, Mark, and Behringer, the guy who has the second most penalty minutes this season for Severna Park, has not scored a goal, doesn't have a point all year, but he's kind of their enforcer.
Yeah, you can see that. I'll tell you what, Jeremy came up big on that one. It was under him, they kept digging. But, you know, when you got a scrum in front of your goaltender, your goaltender's down. I think we're going to get a power play, what?
The thing about it, Mark, I think you have to adjust to the way that officials are calling the game or not calling the game, because many times in Hagerstown, we've seen officials this year blow the whistle when we can see the puck still alive. They were jamming at it. It was clearly underneath the netminder, and we get no penalty here.
No penalty. No. Here we go. Keep going.
Here comes Sean Kreps leading the charge for the North Stars on the rush and a low shot that Danko is able to scoop up on the short hop. Like a short stop. That was a quick shot, and I think the element of surprise may have gotten to him a little bit, but Danko's still able to make the save, and no harm done as he comes up with another big play. And I was mentioning Danko only 5 goals allowed over the last half dozen games, so he has been a tough guy to dent. The North Stars with 1 on the board, but it's gonna take more than that tonight with this game knotted at 1 and in deep. It's broken up by Severna Park and a breakout. Here comes Bondra, and he is stopped. The puck's still loose, and Jeremy scrambles to make the save. Wow, that puck just laid there, and Jeremy was able to dive back on it and make the save before all the bodies come together in the crease. And as a matter of fact, the Severna Park player wound up in the net, but the puck did not. That was Sting Code who was in the net.
I'm speechless on that one, but it's a fantastic save right there. You know, he got a one-on-one breakaway, but then after the shot, it was just laying there on the goal line. Wow.
And we've got a penalty on Severna Park.
All right, well, we'll get to go on the power play.
Finn Code will go to the box. We'll get the announcement upcoming, but the important thing, a power play for the North Stars is second period being brought to you by Fox's Pizza Den. This will be a Fox's Pizza Den power play for the North Stars. First of the night as Code goes to the penalty box with 4 minutes and 19 seconds having expired here in this second period, and an opportunity for the North Stars to take the lead for the first time tonight. And Code's penalty is a slashing call. So a 2-minute minor to Code. And now a giveaway, and Jesse Coleman with one shot, nothing there. And another steal by Zach St. Lawrence. And St. Lawrence able to kill off some precious time, even though he never got a shot off. And now Kreps ahead to Barron. Barron enters the zone. Kreps right down the middle. Barron fires wide from the right side. Deflects to the near side and then played out by Kuhlman and back the other way. Severna Park has scored a lot of shorthanded goals this season.
I can see they've had the scoring opportunity on this so far.
10 shorthanded goals this season for Severna Park. So you have to be careful when you're on the power play not to give them the opportunity. Shot from the point by El Mahandas, but no rebound as Severna Park was there in front defensively to clear it out. Very sound in the defensive end. Now Kyle Omar all the way in. And a good poke check made by Jake Seifert, who was down on his belly, able to swipe it off the stick of Omar. And the puck is hammered the length of the ice. It got by Jeremy Bender, comes to the near side, and Ryan Fry first to it for Severna Park. And takes a hit from Omar behind the net, and Barron scoops up the loose puck. Barron shovels it ahead to Biggs. Biggs gets to the red line, but it's sent back the other way by Wheaton. And right back to Biggs. Biggs at the blue line, plays it off the boards to himself. Far side across now to Barron. High slot. And stopped there by Jake Seibel. Down to 15 seconds remaining on the power play. North Stars retreat into their own end. Di Mercurio for Kreps went by him, but out to Zervis at the red line. Zervis enters the zone. 5 seconds left on the power play opportunity for Washington County. Down deep, Seibel and Zervis. Seibel wins that. Around to the far side to Brooks, and now down deep again. And this time it's Zervis who gets it to Brooks, and his shot was a weak one. And knocked down by Danko. That may have been deflected, might have been the reason, but there wasn't a whole lot on it. Danko able to save it. North Stars keep up the pressure. Di Mercurio, however, slips, and the puck comes loose. And here comes Severna Park. Seibel plays it off the boards in deep for Fry, and it will be an offside against Severna Park. Fry was over the line prior to the pass. 8:16 remaining in the second period. And the faceoff will come all the way back down in the Severna Park end. And even though the North Stars were unable to capitalize on the power play, they've really gotten a little extra pep in their step seemingly since then as they've kept up the pressure. And now, due to the Severna Park miscue, the offside, a chance once again for Washington County to turn up the wick here in the Falcon zone with a faceoff win. And Brooks gets it back. Shot from the point by Omar. It was gloved by Danko, and he'll hang on. And they'll do it again from the same spot. Brooks again on the draw. This time, the puck shoots out to the side instead of back behind him. But Brooks able to get it from Lifke. Plays it in deep. In the corner, Zervis lost it. And it's Sheldon for Severna Park. Around to the near side to Eric Manning. And Manning will play it all the way down. And the faceoff will again come back in the Severna Park end. 7:52 left to play in the second period. Still even at one. North Stars will make a line change here. As the line of Barron, Biggs, and Zervis back on the ice, and Barron on the faceoff wins it back to Biggs. Biggs to El Mahandas from the high slot, broken up, and taking that one right in the solar plexus was Zach St. Lawrence, and St. Lawrence will get a whistle for the injury. And Kyle Omar helps him up. St. Lawrence still feeling the ill effects of that one. He'll have a seat on the Severna Park bench. Yet another faceoff coming up in the Falcons' defensive zone. This one will be a little further out, just inside the blue line. And it's Fry against Barron, and won by Severna Park as Finn Cove shovels it ahead to Bondra. Bondra, great stick handling move. Bondra with a beautiful stick handle. Mark, but it all started with the face-off loss. Ryan Fry able to win it, and then you get Bondra out in the open ice like that. Everybody up at the other end. Bondra able to skate by everybody. Puts it in to make it 2-1. So we're just over halfway through the second period. Smyrna Park reclaims the lead. Cole picks up his second assist. Shot on Danko is turned away as Barron and Zervis team up trying to get an equalizer again. Out in front for Biggs, and he swung and missed. And here comes Bondra again. Only Zacharias back. Barron joins the rush, and the puck deflects to Bender, who will cover it up. And we'll get a timeout. 6:53 left to play second period. Severna Park back on top, 2-1. Class 1A Maryland State Hockey Championship. Severna Park back on top of Washington County, 2-1. Nick Bondra has scored both Severna Park goals in this game. Travis Biggs with the only marker for the North Stars. And now Washington County forced to try to play catch up again against Travis Danko and this Severna Park team. Nick Bondra certainly has shown off his skills in this contest, in particular on that last goal. Most of that was him. Fry winning the faceoff, Code getting him the puck, and then Bondra really doing the rest as the North Stars could not recover. There's still plenty of time remaining in this hockey game. The North Stars really need the next goal. They need to get this back to even. Sean Krebs from the high slot. Shot deflected wide of the net to the left of the netminder. And Severna Park looking to break out, and Bondra was looking to get behind everybody and nearly had a chance to. Instead, Elmahonda is able to track down the bouncing puck on the Washington County defensive side, plays it back out to neutral. Now Omar circles behind the North Stars net and back out. Gets to the red line, ahead for Krebs, but too far. That one was poke checked ahead. And now back into the Washington County end, and Severna Park able to get to it first. But not much happening there. Bodies hit the ice. James McKinney. Eric Manning with the shot from the point. I'm not sure if he got a stick on it in front, but
it was a beautiful tip. I think as he saw it change direction, he got right up in the roof of the net.
So at the 9:46 mark of the second period, 1:59 after the last
scoring his first of the playoffs, number 21, James McKinney.
Somebody. It looks like Josh Barron. Oh boy. We've just gone down 2 goals, and now we got to kill a penalty. Oh boy.
Assisted by number 9, Eric Manning. Time for the goal, 9:26.
Yeah, this is not the formula that Washington County wanted to whip up here, down by 2 goals. Josh Barron to the penalty box.
Josh Barron. 2 minutes for boarding, time on the penalty.
So Barron 38. Gets a boarding penalty, a 2 minute minor. And that's a bit of a frustration penalty. Just over 5 minutes remaining in the second period. North Stars are going to have to dig deep now against All-State first team goaltender, Travis Danko. And a steal by Travis Biggs, but he was never able to get control of the puck, and Danko was closer to it, and he came out and got it and played it around. Danko this season has held the opposition to 2 goals or fewer in 14 of the 16 games he has played coming into tonight. So 14 times this season the opposition has scored 2 goals or fewer against Severna Park, and the North Stars are going to need at least 3 to win this hockey game.
And need 4. Win.
Well, 3.
3 more.
Yeah.
Yeah. off the face-off. Won by the North Stars, and they will retreat into their own end on the penalty kill, but then a bit of bad luck as the puck deflected on the clearing attempt by DiMercurio up into the protective netting on the near side off of Finley Cove. Faceoff will come just outside the blue line of the North Stars defensive zone. Zervis tried to shovel it the length of the ice, but Bailey Pottinger able to knock it down for Severna Park and plays it back in. And now here comes Bondra. Bondra! Way too easy. I mean, Bondra just played it right across the cone. Hawkins, but just made no mistake on it. And it's 4-1. So a power play goal. The second power play goal of the game by Severna Park.
Time on the goal, 10:48.
So Bondra has now had three of the four Severna Park goals in this game. But now the North Stars with an even bigger hole to climb out of. And Drew Brooks trying to get the puck. But a good defensive play by Joe Whedon to swipe the puck off of Brooks' stick. And Severna Park gets it out of the zone with 3:27 remaining in the second period. Three second period goals here coming in a span of 1 minute and 21 seconds. And looking for more now. And the shot goes wide by Kuhlman. Sean Kreps scoops up the loose puck back into the Severna Park end. Veers to his left, now behind the net, looking for somebody in front. Out to Obar, shot from the high slot, bouncing puck. Is covered up by Danko with exactly 3 minutes to play in the second period. And Mark, you said, you gotta stay out of the penalty box. Two of the four goals that Severna Park has scored have come on the power play.
Yeah, and on the penalty kill.
So a 4-1 lead now for Severna Park and 18 minutes of regulation hockey remaining. North Stars need to chip away. They would really love to get one here before this period ends. Barron bouncing puck, didn't get much on the shot. In front, Zervis shoots, Danko looked behind him, didn't go in, and neither does the follow off the rebound, and Barron is hauled down and will get a penalty.
I say, like you said, you just got to chip it away. And if they're going to do it, it's going to be in comeback style, because this second period, it's been some bad breaks, and got to give credit to that Severna Park has made their opportunities.
Well, I thought we were getting a penalty there, but they said the net came off, and that's why they blew the whistle. So, my apologies. Barron was on the ice. Two Severna Park players had taken him down as he was trying to get that one past Danko, but the ruling was that the net had come off the mooring. So, no penalty. North Stars do not go on a power play. And we continue at even strength here with Washington County down three, and Bondra. Again, a magician with the stick, gets it back to Cohen, and a great save by Benda on that one, right off the shoulder, and now here comes Barron back the other way. Barron taken down by Fly, and again, no call. And the North Stars retreat with DiMercurio playing it off the boards to Fly. Now the pass goes through the legs of Zervis, back into the Washington County defensive zone. DiMercurio plays it through the middle, nobody touches it, it'll be an icing call. With 1:55 remaining in the second period.
Wow, it just seems that we just can't create anything from scoring off the point. Severna Park does a very good job of getting back and keeping you from getting any kind of a high scoring off the point.
And they've been very sound on the defensive end and very steady throughout the course of this game. The North Stars' only goal coming on that Travis Biggs effort. It was pretty much all Travis in the first period. Elmahandas from the blue line, all deflected, but it never got through, and Severna Park turns it back the other way.
You can see why Danko is such a good goalie. He does not give up those juicy rebounds at all. North Stars have been on the doorstep awaiting them all night, but they just haven't come. Now off the glass from above the net. The puck bounced out to Krebs, and Krebs had a great chance at one there. Again, Danko able to slide over. I'm not sure he was ever able to get that one on net. 1:10 to play in the second period. North Star's deficit is 3. Preps for Lifke. Lifke's shot deflected wide off the skate of Bailey Pottinger. El Mahandas at center. Plays it rink wide to Omar. Omar feeds it to Brooks. Brooks had it broken up, and right now Severna Park just sending everybody back to break up any offensive chances. And a big save by Benda on the blast by Ryan Fry, who got free atop the left faceoff circle. 40 seconds remaining in the second period, a period that Severna Park has owned.
I was going to say, this has been a good period. I mean, quite honestly, 14 for the effort they're getting on the road, a lot worse than this.
Off the faceoff, Code forces it in behind the net. And then Fry gets it out to Bondra. Bondra dumps it in front, backhander by Code. And again, Benda makes the save. And then contact from Bondra. And then we're going to get Fry, who is the leading penalty getter on the Severna Park team, as well as the leading goal scorer, getting in the face of one of the North Stars. And that very easily could have been a roughing call. We'll see if there is any call at all.
Nope.
Nothing. So they just call incidental extracurriculars in front of the net, hand out a few warnings, and they play on. Face off outside the blue line in Washington County defensive zone, won by Severna Park. Zacharias for Washington County sends it out, and this is going to be an icy call. The faceoff's going to come back down to the Washington County end. Right now, that line of Fry, Bondra, and Code has been so dangerous for Severna Park out there. North Stars control the faceoff, though. El Mahanis, boy, just did it. Was able to skip it by Bondra. Biggs now will bang it around the boards the other way as the second period expires. And at the end of 2, from the Gardens Ice House in Laurel, it is Severna Park leading Washington County by a score of 4-1. And the teams will head to the locker rooms to take an extended break here in between the second and third periods as they resurface the ice. And the North Stars can use a break from this one. They need to formulate some strategy and need to bring all of their effort in the third period. They've got nothing to lose in this game, down now by 3 at the end of 2. It's going to take a Herculean effort by the North Stars, but this is a team with a lot of resolve. We'll see what they've got in the third period. We'll take a 2-minute timeout, here in between the second and third periods, and Mark and I will be back right after this break.
But he's also, he's very smart. Like that short-handed goal, I mean, that was very smart. And of course, there again, a defensive breakdown while we were on the power play, which that one really stung. But I mean, when he got that one-on-one breakaway, I mean, he just beautiful. What else can you say?
And Travis Datsu to secure a 3-peat. If not, Severna Park is going to win its first ever state championship. Mark and I will be back with the third period of action. Back to the ice house, or the Gardens Ice House tomorrow, right after this. Welcome back to Laurel as we get set for the third period of action. North Stars trailing Severna Park 4-1.
right now all the momentum, all the energy on that Severna Park side. And for the North Stars, somehow you have to conjure up that energy. Have to just forget about the fact that you're down by 3 goals. Mentioned it before, obviously it's true. You can only score 1 goal at a time, and that's what the North Stars need to concentrate on here, is getting the first one in this third period. Before you can get the second goal, you have to get the first one. Before you can get the third one, you have to get the second one. So one at a time here for Washington County in this third period. And again, we're talking about a lot of experienced guys over there in terms of playing in this particular hockey game. Now, maybe not being down by 3 goals on this stage, but if ever you were going to count on experience to mean something in a game where the prize is this big, it would be right now for Washington County. Again, they've been outshot by just one in this game, 15-14. But Severna Park with a big second period, 3-0 over the North Stars in that middle frame. And if you look at the main culprit for Severna Park, it has to be Nick Bondra, who has 2 goals and an assist. So he has a hand in 3 of the 4 goals that Severna Park has scored. And Fing Code, we could say the same of. He has a hand in 3 of the 4 with a goal and 2 assists. 2 of the 4 goals scored in this game by Severna Park have come on the power play. Top line out there for the North Stars to open the third period. Top line for Severna Park. We are underway. And the faceoff won by Severna Park, and a shot by Fry right off the faceoff. Are you kidding me? Benda has to make the save. And right now, Mark, not just because of that, but look at the two benches right now.
Yeah, one standing and one sitting.
And guess which one's standing? The one that has the lead in this game, not the one that needs to find the energy here to start this third period and make a push. North Stars finally able to wrest the puck away, and Biggs gets it out to center, but Fry able to tie him up, lays it to the far side off the boards. Elmahondas could not get it on his stick for more than a moment, and then Fing Code sends it in deep. And now Bondra shouldered to the ice by Barron, and now a shot that deflects up and over. I think Benda had to get a piece of that one.
Starting off this third period, Severna Park, that's on the offense, and the North Stars need to turn this around real quick and in a hurry.
I think another thing the North Stars are experiencing tonight that they haven't seen much at all this season is this physical play from Severna Park. I don't know that another team's been even close to this physical with the North Stars this year.
It's that, and it's the speed of the team. There's another shot they got on there.
Severna Park just flying to start this third period. Back to the blue line. Wheaton shoots. That one deflected off the skate of Zacharias. Unfortunately for the North Stars, went to the far side. Tracked down by Kuhlman. And now Manning, who has an assist in this game off a huge shot earlier that was deflected in by McKinney for the third goal of the contest for the Falcons. North Stars spending a lot of time in their own end, and tough to score from there. We've already seen 1:20 tick off the clock in this third period. Seibel for Severna Park in his own end, tried to play it around the glass, and that one skips up and over. And we'll have a faceoff coming in the Severna Park end, and this is where the North Stars need to win the faceoff, keep the puck down here, and get something going where they can cycle the puck a little bit and put some pressure on Danko. They just need to keep throwing it on net until it goes in, but off the faceoff, it skips by Elmahondas at the point. Fry chases it down, but Elmahondas gets there to block him off of it. Omar also got back for the North Stars, but that was pretty much the opposite of what Washington County had hoped for off that faceoff. Severna Park taking its time, and the feed from Fry to Bondra, but Bondra's stick was bothered by Zervis, and his shot thus deflected wide. Didn't get much of anything on it. Bondra and Zervis. Bondra in front for Fry, and that almost wound up being a shot. Benda saw it go just wide of the post. Now Zervis sends Biggs out, but he was too far ahead. Tried to hand it out to Travis near the red line, but it was too far for him. Now a battle in front of the Severna Park bench. Won by Bondra. We got a penalty. A penalty coming up on Severna Park.
Well,
get back in this game. Here is the opportunity. You almost feel a must to score on this power play. I didn't even go so far as to maybe recommend that Coach Blackwood call a timeout right here and get something lined up to be able to get down there and score.
Yeah, I mean, it's very, very important right now for the North Stars to get something on the board here.
Park penalty, number 27, Finley Cody. You have to shoot in half. Time of the penalty, 2:13.
So it's Finn Cody who goes to the box for Smyrna Park. Tripping call.
2 minutes for tripping.
As the North Stars go on the power play here in this third period, presented by Locust Point Market. Locust Point Market power play for the North Stars. Not starting well as Omar got a shot. It looked like the North Stars were going to be able to set something up, and then the puck came to the point and Elmahannis was unable to keep it in, and it went the length of the ice, and North Stars have to start over. Here comes Kreps now. Kreps forced to the right faceoff circle. Retraces his steps, drops it out to the blue line. Omar winds and fires, deflected in front, but it went wide. Bailey Pottinger was in there in front of his netminder. May have gotten a piece of it. Jam attempt in front by Barron, and that would not find its way in. Now Kreps down low to Josh Barron. Off the boards. Out to Elmahannis. Shot deflected high and up into the netting in the ceiling and back down with 11:44 to go in the period. 58 seconds on the power play. You've got to find the net here.
Well, they were able to set up offensively in the power play and cycle the puck, but the shot attempts were blocked and went wide. I mean, still a nothing on Danko.
Smyrna Park really protecting their goalie here, and the faceoff is won by Fry. And the race for the puck won by Omar. Fry hustled back against Kyle, but Kyle able to play it to the near side, and Biggs emerges with it. Biggs to Kreps, back to Biggs, into the Smyrna Park zone. 40 seconds left on the power play. Back out to the point to Omar. Omar banks it off the boards to Barron. Barron, backhanded feed to nobody in the corner, taken away by Jake Seibel. Played around to the near side. Biggs gets it back for Washington County. Again, around the board. Down low, Barron in front, Biggs, he scores!
Well, there's what they needed.
Travis Biggs, with his seventh power play goal of the season, assisted by Josh Barron. We'll see if they give another helper on that one. But it's now 4-2. As the North Stars break through.
North Stars to power cut their play goals. His second goal of the game. Fourth goal of the playoffs, number 10, Travis.
So we'll see if that provides some energy for the North Stars. It's steal by Brooks. He shoots off the glove of Danko.
And
up into the protective netting above the glass,
time of the goal, behind 3, the net. 54.
The lone assist goes to Barron.
By number 10, Travis Biggs.
So in this game, we've now had 6 goals scored, and 3 of them have come on the power play.
Josh Barron, time of the
2 for Smyrna Park, and 1 54. For Washington County. Off the faceoff, Di Mercurio shot blocked by Fry. Puck loose in the faceoff circle to the left of Danko and cleared out by Smyrna Park back to center. Now Bondra. Bondra offside at the blue line. North Stars fortunate there. Able to slow Bondra down enough that he had to change directions, and that caused an offside. Let's see if this power play goal energizes this team a little bit, Mark.
Well, that's what I was wondering, if it was going to give them some energy, but they got their number one line out there with Bondra and Fry out there, and they're so dangerous.
Yeah, you have to be careful because right now the North Stars are so offensive-minded. But you cannot afford to give up a goal. You worked so hard to get one back. Off the faceoff, Finley Cove feeds across for Fry, and Fry couldn't settle it down. Fry now gets it back, though, as he was able to trap it along the boards. Back out to the point, Seifert. Seifert goes wide of the net with that one, bangs it around far side. Zervis gets there for the North Stars. Ahead to Brooks. Brooks tried to tip it ahead, but Seifert was there to play it back toward the Washington County end and into the zone to Cove. And now Fry across to Bondra. Bondra in the right faceoff circle, never got through. Di Mercurio blocked it. Michael tries to get out of there with it, could not. Brooks ahead for Barron, and Barron just had it skip over his stick, and that will be a
that icing call.
Wow, boy, that was so close to being potentially something big, Mark.
Yeah, I mean, Severna Park was controlling the flow of the play in their zone, and, you know, you got to do things like cherry pick a little bit, and that's what Josh Barron was doing. They just missed him, but when you miss him as a result, it's an icing that comes back in front of your goal.
Faceoff will come to the right of Benda. Coolman for Severna Park against Biggs for Washington County. Travis able to win it back to Kyle Omar. Omar around the lefty on the far side boards to Biggs. And boy, it looked like that one came out of the zone. I guess it did, because it delayed offside. Severna Park able to pinch it back into the zone though with Max Cole going in deep to the corner. Now El Mahandas has it for the North Stars. Gets tied up by Max Cole. Cole plays it into the near corner. And then finally out by Kreps. Here's a little two-on-one. Kreps and Biggs broke it up. Back to Leipke. Shoots in. That one's turned aside by Danko. North Stars had the numbers, but they didn't get the guy they probably wanted to take the shot. Ultimately wind up with it. But they still continue to work hard here. North Stars vacate the zone and now back in off the delayed offside. Leipke along the far side boards. Had it stripped away. And Coolman able to force it out. Now picked up by Seibel. And Jake Seibel just as far as the Washington County blue line, and that's all. Down to 8:50 to go. North Stars trailing by two, and Kreps firing it in, but it goes out of play. And that will stop the clock with 8:47 remaining. North Stars have cut the deficit in half. Now looking for goal number three, trying to make this a one-goal game. This draw will come just inside the Severna Park blue line. And it's won by Fry. Back out to Zacharias of Washington County, who sends it back into the Severna Park zone. Stays there only a moment. Now Barron at the blue line, keeps it in. Off to Zervis and broken up by Tom Sheldon.
Zervis. They do such a nice job of breaking those things up.
Boy, do they ever. They really make you work hard. Any goal you score against them, you really do earn it. Barron behind the net. Trying to get it in front. It squirts in front. Nobody home though. And then it's forced out of the zone. Boy, a couple of bad breaks there for the North Stars. And now Bondra skates by DiMercurio. It had no angle. Good job by Benda to cut it down the angle coming all the way to the post. And we get a whistle at
what
the
are we? High stick?
I don't know. What happened was the Severna Park player actually ducked down. He went down, and he's going to get a penalty. Are the North Stars getting one, too?
Yes, they are.
Oh,
Mike
man.
Padima, that Mike Padima, he never goes in the box.
We'll have to wait for the announcement on the penalties because I'm a little unsure of exactly what transpired there. I do know one player from each team is in the box. DiMercurio had only taken one penalty all year long. And this is 17th of the season, the 17th game. Jonathan Seibel is in the box for Severna Park. And Michael DiMercurio is in the box for Washington.
Comes on the faceoff.
Face-off win.
Number 36, Michael DiMercurio. Two minutes for nice thinking. Severna Park's number 88, Jonathan Seibel. 2 minutes for boarding. Penalties come at 6:57.
So the penalties boarding to Seibel. Nice thinking to DiMercurio. And Kreps out of chance as he scored it in. And then he had the puck checked away at the last moment.
6:57.
And Bondra back into the Washington County at all. Beautiful pass from behind or below the goal line out in front for Fry. Again, a nice pass by Bondra, but nobody home. Boy, two feeds that were right in a prime spot to put the puck in the net, but nobody home. And now Bondra!
Wow.
In close, and Bender with the save.
He kept them in the game on that one.
Down to 7:12 to play. North Stars trail by two. Alamzad Yakazov to the blue line of Severna Park turned away. Back to Omar. Omar starts from the red line into the Severna Park zone, gains the line, pulls up,
and has the puck stripped away. Drew Brooks regains from the North Stars. Brooks fires it beside the net. Banks out to the near side. Off the boards to Zervis. Zervis parallel to the goal line. Now skates behind the net. Feeds in front. Broken up. Back out to the high slot. Elma Hondas gloved it down and had to get a stick on the ice to pitchfork it back in deep. Zervis knocked down and the puck leaves the zone. Out beyond the blue line. Now back in. North Stars had to vacate. And here comes Fry to center. Takes a hit from Zervis. Zervis also takes the puck in the process. Gets tied up now with Seibel. Able to hand the puck ahead to Yakuzov. And a penalty coming up.
That's going to give the North Stars the power play. Just what they, exactly what they need. It's another opportunity to cut this to a one-goal game.
And we will get a timeout. With 6:13 left to play third period, North Stars with a golden opportunity when we come back trailing 4-2 back to the Gardens Ice House of Laurel in just a moment. Welcome back to Laurel as we get set for the third period of action. The North Stars trailing Suburban Park 4-1. Right now, all the momentum, all the energy on that Suburban Park side. And if you're the North Stars, somehow you have to conjure up that energy. Have to just forget about the fact that you're down by 3 goals. Mentioned it before, obviously it's true, you can only score 1 goal at a time, and that's what the North Stars need to concentrate on here, is getting the first one in this third period. Before you can get the second goal, you have to get the first one. Before you can get the third one, you have to get the second one. So one at a time here for Washington County in this third period. And again, we're talking about a lot of experienced guys over there in terms of playing in this particular hockey game. Now, maybe not being down by 3 goals on this stage, but if ever you were going to count on experience to mean something in a game where the prize is this big, it would be right now for Washington County. Again, they've been outshot by just one in this game, 15-14. But Severna Park with a big second period, 3-0 over the North Stars in that middle frame. If you look at the main culprit for Severna Park, it has to be Nick Bondra, who has 2 goals and an assist. So he has a hand in 3 of the 4 goals that Severna Park has scored. And Fink Code, we could say the same of. He has a hand in 3 of the 4 with a goal and 2 assists. 2 of the 4 goals scored in this game by Severna Park have come on the power play. Top line out there for the North Stars to open the third period. Top line for Severna Park. We are underway. And the faceoff went by Severna Park and a shot by Fry right off the faceoff. Are you kidding me? Benda has to make the save. And right now, Mark, not just because of that, but look at the two benches right now.
Yeah, one standing and one sitting.
And guess which one's standing? The one that has the lead in this game, not the one that needs to find the energy here to start this third period and make a push. North Stars finally able to wrest the puck away, and Biggs gets it out to center, but Fry able to tie him up, lays it to the far side off the boards. Elma Hondas could not get it on his stick for more than a moment, and then Finn Cohn sends it in deep. And now Bondra shouldered to the ice by Barron, and now a shot that deflects up and over. And I think Benda had to get a piece of that one.
Severna Park. Starting off this third period, Severna Park, that's on the offense. And the North Stars need to turn this around real quick and in a hurry.
I think another thing the North Stars are experiencing tonight that they haven't seen much at all this season is this physical play from Severna Park. I don't know that another team's been even close to this physical with the North Stars this year.
It's that and it's the speed of the team. There's another shot they got in there.
Severna Park just flying to start this third period. Back to the blue line, Wheaton shoots. That one deflected off the skate of Zacharias. Unfortunately for the North Stars, went to the far side.
tracked down by Kuhlman. And now Manning, who has an assist in this game off a huge shot earlier that was deflected in by McKinney for the third goal of the contest for the Falcons. North Star spending a lot of time in their own end and tough to score from there. We've already seen a minute and 20 tick off the clock in this third period. Seibel for Severna Park in his own end, tried to play it around the glass, and that one skips up and over. And we'll have a faceoff coming in the Severna Park end, and this is where the North Stars need to win the faceoff, keep the puck down here, and get something going where they can cycle the puck a little bit and put some pressure on Danko. They just need to keep throwing it on net until it goes in, but off the faceoff, it skips by Omahandas at the point. Fry chases it down, but Omahandas gets there to block him off of it. Omar also got back for the North Stars, but that was pretty much the opposite of what Washington County had hoped for off that faceoff. Severna Park taking its time, and the feed from Fry to Bondra, but Bondra's stick was bothered by Zervis, and his shot thus deflected wide. Didn't get much of anything on it. Bondra and Zervis. Bondra in front for Fry, and that almost wound up being a shot. Then they saw it go just wide of the post. Now Zervis sends Biggs out, but he was too far ahead. Tried to hand it out to Travis near the red line, but it was too far for him. Now a battle in front of the Severna Park bench. Won by Bondra, we've got a penalty. A penalty coming up on Severna Park.
Well, if we're going to get back in this game, here is the opportunity. You almost feel a must to score on this power play. I wouldn't even go so far as to maybe recommend that Coach Blackwood call timeout right here and get something lined up to be able to go down there and score.
Yeah, I mean, it's very, very important right now for the North Stars to get something on the board here.
Cut this. Finley Cody.
Deficit in half.
Time
so it's Finn Coe who goes to the box for Severna Park. Tripping call. As the North Stars go on the power play here in this third period, presented by Locust Point Market. Locust Point Market power play for the North Stars. Not starting well as Omar got a shot. It looked like the North Stars were going to be able to set something up, and then the puck came to the point, and Omahandas was unable to keep it in, and it went the length of the ice, and North Stars have to start over. Here comes Krebs now. Krebs forced to the right faceoff circle. Retraces his steps, drops it out to the blue line. Omar winds and fires, deflected in front, but it went wide. Bailey Pottinger was in there in front of his netminder. May have gotten a piece of it. Jam attempt in front by Barron, and that would not find its way in. Now Krebs down low to Josh Barron. Off the boards. Out to Elmahandas. Shot deflected high and up into the netting. In the ceiling and back down with 11:44 to go in the period, 58 seconds on the power play. You've got to find the net here.
Well, they were able to set up offensively on the power play and cycle the puck, but the shot attempts were blocked and went wide. I mean, still a nothing on Danko.
Severna Park really protecting their goalie here, and the faceoff is won by Fry, and the race for the puck won by Omar. Fry hustled back against Kyle, but Kyle able to play it to the near side, and Biggs emerges with it. Biggs to Krebs, back to Biggs, into the Severna Park zone. 40 seconds left on the power play. Back out to the point to Omar. Omar banks it off the boards to Barron. Barron, backhanded feed to nobody in the corner, taken away by Jake Seibel. Played around to the near side. Biggs gets it back for Washington County. Again, around the board. Down low, Barron in front, Biggs, he scores!
And there's what they needed.
Travis Biggs, with his seventh power play goal of the season, assisted by Josh Barron. We'll see if they give another helper on that one, but it's now 4-2 as the North Stars break through.
North Stars to cut their goals for his second goal of the game, fourth goal of the playoffs, number 10, Travis.
So we'll see if that provides some energy for the North Stars to steal by Brooks. He shoots off the glove of Danko.
And
up into the protective netting above the glass.
Time of the goal, behind 3:54.
The lone assist goes to Barrett.
By number 10, Travis Biggs.
So in this game, we have now had six goals scored, and three of them have come on the power play. Two for Severna Park, one for Washington County. Off the faceoff, DiMercurio shot blocked by Fry. Puck loose in the faceoff circle to the left of Danko and cleared out by Severna Park. Back to center. Now Bondra. Bondra offside at the blue line. North Star's fortunate there. Able to slow Bondra down enough that he had to change directions, and that caused an offside. Let's see if this power play goal energizes this team a little bit, Mark.
Well, that's what I was wondering, if it was going to give them some energy, but they got their number one line out there with Bondra and Fry out there, and they're so dangerous.
Yeah, you have to be careful because right now the North Star's so offensive-minded that you cannot afford to give up a goal. You worked so hard to get one back. Off the faceoff, Finley Cove feeds across for Fry, and Fry couldn't settle it down. Fry now gets it back, though, as he was able to trap it along the boards. Back out to the point, Seifert. Seifert goes wide of the net with that one, bangs it around far side. Zervis gets there for the North Stars. Ahead to Brooks. Brooks tried to tip it ahead, but Seifert was there to play it back toward the Washington County end and into the zone to Cove. And now Fry across to Bondra. Bondra in the right faceoff circle, never got through. DiMercurio blocked it. Michael tries to get out of there with it, could not. Brooks ahead for Barrett, and Barrett just had it skip over his stick, and that will be an icing call. Wow, boy, that was so close to being potentially something big, Mark.
Yeah, I mean, Severna Park was controlling the flow of the play in their zone, and, you know, you got to do things like cherry pick a little bit, and that's what Josh Barrett was doing. They just missed him, but when you miss him as a result, it's an icing that comes back in front of your goal.
Faceoff will come to the right of Benda. Kuhlman for Severna Park against Biggs for Washington County. Travis able to win it back to Kyle Omar. Omar around the Lifke on the far side boards to Biggs. And boy, it looked like that one came out of the zone. I guess it did. It called a delayed offside. Severna Park able to pinch it back into the zone though with Max Cohn going in deep to the corner. Now El Mahandas has it for the North Stars. Gets tied up by Max Cohn. Cove plays it into the near corner, and then finally out by Krebs. Here's a little two-on-one. Krebs and Biggs broken up, back to Lifke, shoots in. That one's worth a side by Danko. North Stars had the numbers, but they didn't get the guy they probably wanted to take the shot, ultimately wind up with it. But they still continue to work hard here. North Stars vacate the zone and now back in off the delayed offside. Lifke along the far side boards, had it stripped away. And Kuhlman able to force it out. Now picked up by Seibel. And Jake Seibel just as far as the Washington County blue line, and that's all. Down to 8:50 to go. North Stars trailing by two, and Krebs firing it in, but it goes out of play. And that will stop the clock with 8:47 remaining. North Stars have cut the deficit in half. Now looking for goal number three, trying to make this a one-goal game. This draw will come just inside the Severna Park blue line. And it's won by Fry. Back out to Zacharias of Washington County, who sends it back into the Severna Park zone. Stays there only a moment. Now Barron at the blue line, keeps it in. Off to Zervis and broken up by Tom Sheldon.
They do such a nice job of breaking those things up.
Boy, do they ever. They really make you work hard. Any goal you score against them, you really do earn it. Barron behind the net. Trying to get it in front. It squirts in front. Nobody home, though, and then it's forced out of the zone. Boy, a couple of bad breaks there for the North Stars. And now Bondra skates by DiMercurio. It had no angle. Good job by Benda to cut it down the angle, coming all the way to the post. And we get a whistle at
what
the...
What are we... High stick?
I don't know. What happened was the Severna Park player actually ducked down. He went down, and he's going to get a penalty. Are the North Stars getting one, too?
Yes, they are.
Oh,
Michael
man.
Michael DiMercurio, he never goes in the box.
We'll have to wait for the announcement on the penalties because I'm a little unsure of exactly what transpired there. I do know one player from each team is in the box. Dean Mercurio had only taken one penalty all year long. And this is 17th of the season. The 17th game, Jonathan Seibel is in the box for Severna Park. And Michael DiMercurio is in the box for Washington.
Look out, Bonder comes on the faceoff.
Here's a penalty.
Faceoff win.
Penalty number 36, Michael DiMercurio.
Severna Park.
Severna Park's number 88, Jonathan Seibel. 2 minutes reporting. Penalties number 6:57.
So the penalties, warning for Seibel. High sticking to DiMercurio. And Kratz had a chance as he skated in. And then he had the puck poke checked away at the last moment. And Bondra back into the Washington. Got it all. Beautiful pass from behind or below the goal line out in front for Fry. Again, a nice pass by Bondra, but nobody home. Boy, two feeds that were right in a prime spot to put the puck in the net, but nobody home. And now Bondra!
Wow.
In close, and Bender with the save.
He kept them in the game on that one.
Down to 7:12 to play. North Stars trail by two. Alamzan Yakuzov to the blue line of Severna Park, turned away. Back to Omar. Omar starts from the red line into the Severna Park zone, gains the line, pulls up, and has the puck stripped away. Drew Brooks regains from the North Stars. Brooks fires it beside the net, banks out to the near side, off the boards to Zervis. Zervis parallel to the goal line, now skates behind the net, feeds in front, broken up, back out to the high slot. Elma Hondas gloved it down, then had to get a stick on the ice to pitchfork it back in deep. Zervis knocked down, and the puck leaves the zone out beyond the blue line. Now back in. North Stars had to vacate. And here comes Fry to center. Takes a hit from Zervis. Zervis also takes the puck in the process. Gets tied up now with Seibel. Able to hand the puck ahead to Yakuzov. And a penalty coming up.
That's going to give the North Stars the power play. Just what they, exactly what they need. It's another opportunity to cut this to a one-goal game.
We'll get a timeout with 6:13 left to play third period. North Stars with a golden opportunity when we come back trailing 4-2 back to the Gardens Ice House at Laurel in just a moment.
That's the third time that kid's been in the box, isn't it?
I don't know, that's their captain. Oh, wait a minute. Yeah. Yeah, Jake Seibel, that's the captain.
Josh and Travis have not been in the box.
Barron went, they scored a power play.
Oh, with Barron in?
Yeah. In the third period, power play for the North Stars.
Oh,
and a giveaway right off the faceoff. And it's Zach St. Lawrence who came up with a steal for Severna Park. Fortunately for the North Stars, nothing came of it. And Josh Barron into the zone, back out. Jake Seifert with the defensive play for Severna Park. And the Falcons able to send it all the way down to where Benda has to play it. And the North Stars have already lost 35 seconds of the power play opportunity. And again, they flip it into the zone, but it's Severna Park first to it and back out. Time becoming a major concern now for the North Stars. 5:25 remaining, and they need two goals to tie.
Another one.
And a penalty coming up on Severna Park.
Well, you couldn't ask for much, Bill. Now we're going to get a minute and 7:05. So if the North Stars are going to come back and win this game, the time is now. I think, yeah, the North Stars are going to call timeout, bring the troops over to the bench, get something organized to score. I think I thought I saw a signal timeout.
Nope, 5-on-3 for the North Stars, and they have to have one here. 5-on-3 advantage to Washington County.
Number 32, Jake Seifert, 2 minutes for roughing. Time of the penalty, 9:21.
Here's Travis Banks, he fired! Oh, the North Stars wanted that one. It looked like it hit the inside of the post.
41.
Josh Barron was lobbying for that one, thought that maybe it had gone in. Now here's a backhand! Oh, a shot clip! Another power play goal, Mark, and right now the discipline of Severna Park killing them. I mean, you can have all the talent in the world. You can play as physical as you want to play. You can be a skilled team, but you also have to be smart. Penalties killing them right now. The North Stars within 1:458 to go, 1:39 left on a power play for the North Stars.
North Stars power play goal, scoring his sixth goal in the playoffs. Number 59, Sean.
Josh Barron. Oh, stolen by Bogdan Sunrise. Bogdan back the other way. Knocked off the puck by Barron. Played across to Brooks, and Brooks went for Brooks.
0-2.
But it skipped by him and all the way
down. Washington County goal scored by number 59, Sean Kretz. His sixth goal of the playoffs.
Diggs down, lifts it into the Severna Park end, 4:25 left in the hockey game in regulation. We have 1 minute remaining on the power play. In front, Barron, puck is loose. And it is, wow. Boy, that almost could have been a penalty there on Severna Park for two. By the North Stars, 2:47, and we're even at 4, Mark.
Well,
4-4, nothing.
Timeout, Severna Park.
This is what it comes down to now, Wes. Tie game.
North Stars, power play goal. Scoring his third goal in the playoffs. Number 21, John.
I have to be honest with you, Mark. I don't think the North Stars had much of a chance starting the third period. Not super down. But when the third period started, just their body language. But Severna Park opened the door for the penalties. And Ross McCowdy has walked right through. That'll do it. We're even at 4.
His third goal of the playoffs. Assisted by number 23, Zach Elmo Hernandez. Time of the power play goal, 10:49.
So Barron scores the goal. Elmo Hernandez picks up the assist. And it's a tied hockey game. Now this team from Severna Park played an overtime game in their last one. They beat Annapolis in overtime 3-2. We still have plenty of regulation hockey to go. And we'll see just what happens in this final 3:47, but an even hockey game. And I said it would take a Herculean effort by the North Stars. Well, they've shown their muscles here. And a shot wide by Service. A spinning shot off the feed from Drew Brooks. And now here comes Fry. Fry has Seibel with him, but it's broken up. Omar plays it back out to center. Bondra shovels it right back in. 3:20 left to play third period. Elmahanis gets it to Brooks. Drew Brooks ahead for Zervis. Deflected off his stick. Code may have gotten a piece of it. Zervis goes behind the net, didn't get there fast enough. Now Brooks pinching in the corner. And Brooks taken to the ice. Two men go down, one from each team. Severna Park Seibel, who picked up one of those earlier penalties, the captain went down, and now a knuckleballing shot, and Benda able to save it, and it was Bondra who was breathing down.
Bondra, if he wouldn't have let that puck out in front of him, Bondra would have poked that right in the net.
3 minutes to play in regulation, tied at 4. Boy, if you walked away from the radio at the end of the second period, thinking this one was over, not even close. Anybody's hockey game now with 2:55 to go. North Star startup. Here comes Barron. Barron with Banks. He fires wide. I believe actually that was Zacharias who was with him instead. Barron taking the shot, fired it wide. And man, they had a chance again, a two-on-one. And that's Severna Park student section that had been so quiet. Finally back to their feet here, but their team has given up a three-goal lead in this one. 2.5 minutes to play. A steal by Kuhlman. Kuhlman shoots and Bendis saves. And we're going to stop it with 2:24 remaining. Boy, just the emotions in this game for both teams, for the fans. I mean, this has been a sensational championship hockey.
It has been. Win or lose this game, the North Stars showed a lot of character coming back.
Face-off win by the North Stars, and now Big starts Barron out. It's a two-on-two. Zervis with him. Barron gets by, all the way in front. The feet, backhanded by Biggs. Stopped by Danko.
Oh, I guess didn't have the angle on that, but they created an opportunity, though.
Great work by that line of Barron, Biggs, and Zervis to put the pressure on. Travis Biggs looking for the hat trick and for the go-ahead goal. Just did elude him with 2:11 left to go. Face off to the left of Danko. Biggs with the win. Zervis toward the net. It goes wide. Biggs and Sheldon behind the net. Played around far side to Coe. And the length of the ice. And this one will be coming back down the other way. And boy, now Severna Park looking like a team on the ropes.
Well, what can you say? I mean, they opened up the door with the penalties to let us back in the game. So now it's anybody's game. Anything can happen. You know it's just going to be the bounce of the puck. Who gets the break? Because both, you got two excellent teams going at it.
Severna Park looks like it's just trying to hold on right now. But this game is even at 4. Somebody has to score to end this one. Long pass. And here comes Bondra. And it's broken up by Omar Hodges.
Wow.
Man, oh man.
Bondra cherry picking looking for that one.
Great play by Zach to get back and break that up, and now we'll go back to the other end. But for the North Stars, this is the lesser of two evils to get this faceoff back up at that end, because Bondra was on his way in. Elma just made a big defensive play.
Yeah, he did. I mean, they took the risk with the cherry picking, and he sprung it, but Zach Elma Hendis came out of nowhere to poke it off his stick.
1:40 remaining in regulation. Faceoff to the left of Benda. Forced toward the net by Fry, but then sent around the boards by Kreps. On the near side, big collision sends Zervis to the ice. Puck goes the other way, and Kreps gets it out to center. Biggs couldn't catch up to it. Seibel turns it back into the Washington County end. Now handed ahead to Fry by Code, but Zervis gets to it and forces it back toward the Severna Park end. 75 seconds left in regulation. Seibel retreats to his own end, bangs it off the boards, blocked down by Biggs, and an offside. Oh.
I think they're calling a hand pass to himself on that. Either way, it's going to stop at 108, Wes.
Oh. So the faceoff just outside the Severna Park blue line. Barron to take it against Fry. And the puck got caught up, and Fry able to force it toward the Washington County end. Now able to get to the blue line. Bondra trailing the play. Code into the corner. DiMercurio knocked down. Bondra looking for the puck, but it's taken away. Here comes Kreps. Kreps, one on or two on two now. And Bondra deflects it up and out of play with 48 seconds to go. Faceoff will come to the left of Danko. And a timeout called by the North Stars.
Oh, that's a smart move to call a timeout. Wes, I'm just numb. I don't know what to say. I'll let you do the talking.
This has been
Washington County.
A terrific hockey game. Just a sensational excitement both ways. I think we were in a bit of a lull there for a while because not a lot was happening. It looked like Severna Park had really gained control of this hockey game. But then the North Stars, as I said, they just had to chip away. And it's a lot easier to chip away when the other team gives you some inroads. And that's what Severna Park did. But credit the North Stars, they capitalized. And here we are tied at 4. I don't know that a lot of people who have been watching this game would have given the North Stars a chance to get back to even in this one.
No, I don't think so. I was actually starting to think to myself, I'm like, well, you know, we got this far. And you know, we've won it the last 2 years in a row. There's nothing
all
to put
right,
your head
ladies
down
about. And gentlemen, hey, it's guess what? Time. We're it's gonna, the final minute of regulation.
10 seconds
left in regulation.
North Stars try to hop to it, don't get there in time. Code on the far side for Severna Park. The hit for Fry, oh man, he almost got behind everybody. Yep, Elmahagas again saved the day. Now Barron into the Severna Park end. Goes wide into the corner, 30 seconds to play. Out on top, Brooks fires high over the crossbar. Banks out toward the far side boards. Brooks gets to it again, tied up there. He gets it back, ahead to Banks. He shoots, oh, wide of the high corner of the far side. He went to the stick side trying to lift it up over the shoulder of Danko. Down to 8 seconds. It leaves the zone. Out to center. 5 seconds. Barron with three. He shoots. The save by Danko. Rebound. And he covers up. And we are going to overtime. Timeout. We'll be back with overtime in the Class 1A state championship game right after this. Nothing has been decided. Severna Park in Washington County tied at 4. And in this game, Mark, you can say the first period was clearly a stalemate. Second period was Severna Park's, third period Washington County's.
Yeah, that's a good way to sum it up. This is, you know, this is going to come down to someone's going to get sprung on a breakaway. Somebody, it's going to be the bounce of the puck. That's what this game's about, and that's what playing for a championship's about.
Oh, well, I mentioned earlier the experience of this Washington County team would somehow come to the fore in this game. I think it really did in that third period, but I don't know that anybody expected it all the way up the tank. I was just informed by the commissioner of the MSHL. This is the first time the state championship since 1999 has gone to overtime.
Wow. Well, I'll tell you, it's a privilege to be here to call this game because this has had a little bit of everything.
And how aggressive will these teams be in the overtime? Because again, you don't want to give the other team a power play. And we'll see how the officials call it. Off the faceoff, Severna Park working into the Washington County end. Bondra with a shot deflected by the stick of Kreps. It goes wide, and then Benda will cover it up as it caroms off the boards behind the net. 12 seconds into the third period. Incidentally, we are playing a 10-minute overtime period. It's sudden death, so if somebody scores, it's over immediately. If not, we'll go to a second 10-minute overtime. If nobody scores in that one, we'll go to a shootout. Offside, entering the Severna Park zone by the North Stars. So the faceoff will come outside the blue line with 9:38 to play in the first overtime. Face-off win by the North Stars, and Biggs, who has two of the four goals, plays in the Severna Park end. It gets a steal in front. Oh, Barron tried to sweep it in, and Danko got a toe on it and deflected that one wide to the near side corner. Barron tied up. Zervis plays it around to Biggs. Out to DiMercurio. He partially fanned on the shot, and a steal by Fry. Fly tried to feed in front. Barron broke it up. Back in front, stolen away, DiMercurio. Ahead to Zervis, and Zervis knocked off the puck by Seifert. Back to Kreps. Stolen now by Jake Seifert. And a big hit by the North Stars. And that laid Seifert out. And the North Stars regained the puck, but they can't get it out of the zone. And it finally dribbles out. Oh, who wants it? I think Barron was afraid they were going to call him. Puck played with a high stick there, so he didn't touch it. Played back in from beyond the blue line, and Jeremy Bender will decide, and he'll just cover it up. 8:31
to go in the first overtime.
Tied at 4.
Again, this could be the only overtime. It's sudden death overtime. Face-off to the right of Benda. Results in a scrum along the boards. Puck jammed up. Finally, pride free. Seibel comes away with it for Severna Park. Stolen now by Brooks. Brooks hands it ahead. Here's Barron. 1-on-2. Man, he got tied up by Seibel.
They're not going to call that.
Yeah, they don't call anything. Seibel grabbed him around the waist, but no call. Back the other way now. Omar got it out of the zone, but Manning stole it away for Severna Park, but only momentarily. Zacharias to Biggs. Biggs bumped by Whedon. Now here's Brooks at the blue line. Brooks along the boards now. Brooks battles with Kuhlman. Gets loose from the faceoff circle. Fired it high and over everything. Comes over near side for Omar. Back in front, and Brooks just could barely keep from boy, he nearly reached that one. Back in front. Here's Brooks for Biggs. And it's loose, and Zacharias tracks it down. Zacharias back in front. And Kuhlman, the only one home, sends it the length of the ice. And an icing call, and we'll come back down to the other end. Man, so close.
Oh, Wes, my stomach's turning.
It's been that kind of game, and the North Stars with some great, great pressure and just could not get the puck in the net. Boy, Drew Brooks had a chance there on a possible deflection, and he was just inches short of reaching the puck. 7:20 remaining in the overtime, tied at 4. DiMercurio from the point, blocked down by Danko. He deflects it to the far side boards. Now here's Biggs. Biggs shovels it in front, and Barron is there. It went behind the net, back in front service. Loose in front, it's taken away by Severna Park. Oh man, once again. Boy, that puck was laying there.
It was laying there for the taking.
Oh, so tantalizingly, right in front of the net. Nobody seemed to want it. Severna Park playing a lot of defense here in this overtime. DiMercurio for the North Stars at the red line. Fires it off the boards near side and back in. Jake Seifert gets there first, plays it out the center. Stolen away by Fry. Fry has Bonder waiting. Fry fires. Save Benda! And Krebs takes it away. Jeremy made the save. The puck came loose. Krebs came up with it. Now here comes Barron. Barron shoots. Saved by Danko.
Hit him in the belly. I tell you, that was a heck of a bullet that Fry shot. I mean, he was just going for it. He got a heck of a slap shot.
And I'll tell you what, your head has to be on a swivel when you're a goalie with that line out there, when you got the likes of Fry, their leading goal scorer, Bondra, who can do it all, and Code, who has been a real pain in the butt all day for the North Stars.
Yeah, you feel like you survived that shift, but now they're on the bench. Now we've got Barron, Brooks, and Service.
Off the faceoff, El Mahadas fires, and the save is made. I didn't know if Danko could see that one or not.
I hit him in the belly. If he didn't see it, he felt it.
3 minutes and 43 seconds gone by in the first overtime. Faceoff win by the North Stars. Brooks skates behind the net, sends it out to Omar. Shoots, blocked down. Kuhlman throws it away. And then Elma Hondas takes it back, but gives it away to Jake Seibel. Seibel forced to the far side board to the corner. Now below the goal line. And the battle for the puck rages on there. Finally, Elma Hondas gets it out, and it skips by Bailey Pottinger at the point, and all the way back down to the Severna Park end. Pottinger plays it out to center.
Fry's right back out there.
Yep, so's Code.
And when they come off, it ain't gonna be
here long. Comes Bondra. Bondra's back on the ice too, so all three of them. And the feed through the middle. Bondra couldn't reach it, neither could Fry. Brooks for the North Stars. Turns it back the other way to Biggs. Biggs trying to hand it to Zervis. Stolen by Bondra. Ahead to Fry. Now Bondra slams on the brakes at the blue line and will send it in deep where El Mahandas tracks it down. Halfway through the first overtime. Biggs plays it off his skate too far ahead. Here comes Fry for Severna Park.
Oh!
In front, Bondra.
Oh!
Stars hoped for, but a gutsy effort to come back from 3 goals down. And man, you got to hand it to Severna Park too, because when all the momentum was on the other side, somehow they muster up enough at the end, and Nick Bondra saves them with a goal here just over halfway through overtime.
Number 12,
Nick Bondra. That was on a
rebound. He can flash the net and hook in the rebound.
Unassisted. Time of the goal, 5-0-8.
Tell you what, Coach Blackwood talking to his team right now. He has them all gathered together. I'm sure there are some tears down there on the Washington County side right now. Those guys have nothing to be ashamed of. Crediting the North Stars for making it all the way to this championship game, but you know, this isn't the way that it normally ends for Washington County. But I'm telling you what, Mark, out of the championship games that we've seen the North Stars win, I don't know, as you mentioned the word earlier, I don't know if they've ever shown more character. Yes, they didn't get the cup down, but man, did they show character.
Number 21, Josh Barron.
Like I said, it was going to be a bounce of a punch or something.
A 5-4 win, but
now, and
an incredible team effort on both sides in this game.
The president of
the North Stars really coming back
and
from the end in many ways in that third period, scoring 3 goals
to
tie this game up and even get it to overtime. And in the extra session, Mark, the North Stars just had so many more chances than Severna Park. It was almost agonizing not to get that game-winning goal.
Yeah, I mean, they had opportunities. They just never really got that knockout shot that could create it. I mean,
and now, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, please pay your attention to
just off the stick
rights
and knocking it off.
Will the captain of the Washington County North Stars please skate forward and claim your 2012-2013
MSHL. We have an allegiance certainly to the North Stars without question. You more than I do, for sure, but is this the best high school hockey game that you've seen?
Yes. Even though we didn't win, that's the way that they came back.
And
the fact that it went deep into a sudden death overtime, I mean, it was a nail biter. I mean, last year we came in here and rolled right over Queen Anne's County, and it really wasn't much of a game. This one here, well, what can you say? It leaves you speechless.
Yeah, again, congratulations to Severna Park.
Oh, absolutely.
A heck of a team.
And
this was just two really good teams. If this was the best game of 7 series, they would go 7 games in an overtime.
Yeah, it's really a shame that the North Stars don't get to play a team like this more often, and we know why. I mean, the North Stars, obviously, in the western region of the state, Severna Park in the eastern region, it's not one of those things that, from a travel standpoint, is one that you can make happen very easily.
But, man, this was really a classic here tonight. You know, they talk about ESPN classics, how games are played, and they wind up on air. You know, within the next day or two, this is one of those that will live in our memories for a long time.
Oh, yeah.
Unfortunately,
I'll never forget it.
Yeah, unfortunately, the North Stars don't get the W here, but, I mean, what a run for a team that had won back-to-back and had an opportunity here to make it three in a row. And I have a feeling, based on history, that the North Stars just aren't going away anytime soon.
Nope. They'll look different, but they'll be back.
Well, you get Josh Barron back. You get Travis Biggs back. You get
Omar.
Jeremy Benda back.
Omar Elmo Hendez.
Right. I mean, yeah, so many guys.
Still a core. There will still be a core guys. Like I said, they'll look different. The younger guys on the team that, you know, they'll be a year older. You know, I was thinking Severna Parks, Denko is a senior. I'm wondering, do they have one coming up through the ranks? I've seen that happen many times. That, you know, you ride that goalie for 4 years, but once he graduates, you got to have another one come in.
Yeah,
one thing the North Stars, since day one, have always had, they've always had rock-solid goaltenders.
Yeah, there's no question about that. I mean, the only North Stars jersey that's ever been retired, the only number ever retired, belongs to their first-ever goalie. But, you know, I don't know what Severna Park has in the pipeline. They only have one goalie on their varsity roster, so I don't know what they might have in terms of a goalie on the front of the team.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again,
but I can't say that this team will play here tonight. Very solid team. North Stars took advantage of everything that Severna Park gave them in that third period. And Severna Park earned this one. The North Stars really made them earn it in the end. And again, just a great hockey game. Off the faceoff, the puck directed toward the net, but it goes wide. North Stars try to hop to it, don't get there in time. Code on the far side for Severna Park. The hit for Fry. Oh, man, he almost got behind everybody. Yep, Elmahagas again saved the day. Now Barron into the Severna Park end. Goes wide into the corner, 30 seconds to play. Out on top, Brooks fires high over the crossbar. Banks out toward the far side boards. Brooks gets to it again. Tied up there. He gets it back. Ahead to Biggs. He shoots all wide of the high corner on the far side. He went to the stick side trying to lift it up over the shoulder of Danko. Down to 8 seconds. It leaves the zone. Out to center. 5 seconds. Barron with three. He shoots. The save by Danko. Rebound. And he covers up. And we are going to overtime. A 1 minute timeout. We'll be back with overtime in the Class 1A state championship game right after this. Nothing has been decided. Severna Park in Washington County tied at 4. And in this game, Mark, you can say the first period was clearly a stalemate. Second period was Severna Parks. Third period, Washington County's.
Yeah, that's a good way to sum it up. This is, you know, this is going to come down to someone's going to get sprung on a breakaway. Somebody, it's going to be the bounce of the puck. That's what this game's about, and that's what playing for a championship's about.
Oh, well, I mentioned earlier the experience of this Washington County team would somehow come to the fore in this game. I think it really did in that third period, but I don't know that anybody expected the way
I was just informed by the commissioner of the MSHL. This is the first time the state championship since 1999 has gone to overtime.
Wow. Well, I'll tell you, it's a privilege to be here to call this game, because this has had a little bit of everything. And how aggressive will these teams be in the overtime? Because again, you don't want to give the other team a power play. And we'll see how the officials call it. Off the faceoff, Severna Park working into the Washington County end. Bondra with a shot deflected by the stick of Kreps. It goes wide, and then Benda will cover it up as it caroms off the boards behind the net. 12 seconds into the third period. incidentally, we are playing a 10-minute overtime period. It's sudden death, so if somebody scores, it's over immediately. If not, we'll go to a second 10-minute overtime. If nobody scores in that one, we'll go to a shootout. Offside, entering the Severna Park zone by the North Stars. So the faceoff will come outside the blue line with 9:38 to play in the first overtime. Faceoff win by the North Stars, and Biggs, who has two of the four goals, plays in the Severna Park. I think it's a steal in front. Oh, Barron tried to sweep it in, and Danko got a toe on it and deflected that one wide to the near side corner. Barron tied up. Zervis plays it around to Biggs. Out to DiMercurio. He partially fanned on the shot. And a steal by Fry. Fry tried to feed in front. Barron broke it up. Back in front. Stole it away. DiMercurio. And head to Zervis. And Zervis knocked off the puck by Seifert. Back to Kreps. Stolen now by Jake Seifert. And a big hit by the North Stars. And that laid Seifert out. And the North Stars regained the puck, but they can't get it out of the zone. And it finally dribbles out. Oh, who wants it? I think Barron was afraid they were going to call him. Puck played with a high stick there, so he didn't touch it. Played back in from beyond the blue line, and Jeremy Bender will decide, and he'll just cover it up. 8:31 to go in the first overtime. Tied at four. Again, this could be the only overtime. It's sudden death overtime. Face-off to the right of Benda. Results in a scrum along the boards. Puck jammed up. Finally pried free. Seibel comes away with it for Severna Park. Stolen now by Brooks. Brooks hands it ahead. Here's Barron. One on two. Man, he got tied up by Seibel. Yeah, they don't call anything. Seibel grabbed him around the waist, but no call. Back the other way now. Omar got it out of the zone, but Manning stole it away for Severna Park, but only momentarily. Zacharias to Biggs. Biggs bumped by Whedon. Now here's Brooks at the blue line. Brooks along the boards now. Brooks battles with Kuhlman. Gets loose from the faceoff circle. Fired it high and over everything. Comes over near side for Omar. Back in front, and Brooks just could barely keep from reaching. Boy, he nearly reached that one. Back in front. Here's Brooks for Biggs. And it's loose, and Zacharias tracks it down. Zacharias back in front. And Kuhlman, the only one home. And sends it the length of the ice. And an icing call, and we'll come back down to the other end. Man, so close.
Oh, Wes. My stomach's turning.
It's been that kind of game, and the North Stars with some great, great pressure and just could not get the puck in the net. Boy, Drew Brooks had a chance there on a possible deflection, and he was just inches short of reaching the puck. 7:20 remaining in the overtime. Tied at four. DiMercurio from the point. Blocked down by Danko. He deflects it to the far side boards. Now here's Biggs. Biggs shovels it in front, and Barron is there. It went behind the net. Back in front, Zervis. Loose in front. It's taken away by Severna Park. Oh, man, once again. Boy, that puck was laying there.
It was laying there for the taking.
Oh, so tantalizingly, right in front of the net. Nobody seemed to want it. Severna Park playing a lot of defense here in this overtime. DiMercurio for the North Stars at the red line. Fires it off the boards near side and back in. Jake Seifert gets there first, plays it out the center. Stolen away by Fry. Fry has Bonder waiting. Fry fires. Save Bender. And Kreps takes it away. Jeremy made the save. The puck came loose. Kreps came up with it. Now here comes Barron. Barron shoots. Saved by Danko.
Hit him in the belly. I tell you, that was a heck of a bullet that Fry shot. I mean, he was just going for it. He's got a heck of a slot shot.
And I'll tell you what, your head has to be on a swivel when you're a goalie with that line out there, when you got the likes of Fry, their leading goal scorer, Bondra, who can do it all, and Code, who has been a real pain in the butt all day for the North Stars.
Yeah, you feel like you survived that shift, but now they're on the bench. And we've got Barron, Brooks, and Zervis.
off the faceoff. Elmahadis fires and the save is made. I didn't know if Danko could see that one or not.
I hit him in the belly. If he didn't see it, he felt it.
3 minutes and 43 seconds gone by in the first overtime. Faceoff win by the North Stars. Brooks skates behind the net, sends it out to Omar. Shoots, blocked down. Pittman throws it away. And then Elmahandas takes it back, but gives it away to Jake Seibel. Seibel forced to the far side, boards to the corner, now below the goal line. And the battle for the puck rages on there. Finally, Elmahandas gets it out, and it skips by. Bailey Pottinger at the point, and all the way back down to the Severna Park end. Pottinger plays it out to center.
Fry's right back out there.
Yep, so's Code.
And when they come off, it ain't gonna be
the ball. Here comes Bondra. Bondra's back on the ice too, so all three of them. And the feed through the middle. Bondra couldn't reach it, neither could Fry. Brooks for the North Stars. Turns it back the other way to Biggs. Biggs trying to hand it to Zervis. Stolen by Bondra. Ahead to Fry. Now Bondra slams on the brakes at the blue line and will send it in deep where Elmahandas tracks it down. Halfway through the first overtime. Biggs plays it off his skate too far ahead. Here comes Fry for Severna Park.
Oh!
Here comes Bondra.
Number two star for the Severna Park with a goal and two assists, number 27,
takes the second shot.
Finley Bondra.
Win, but
now, ladies and gentlemen,
an incredible
team
effort on both sides in this game.
Welcome the president of
the North Stars, really
Paul Lofgren,
coming back from
the
dead in many ways in that third period, scoring three goals
to
tie this game up and even get it to overtime. And in the extra session, Mark, the North Stars just had so many more chances than Sigourney Park. It was almost agonizing not to get that game-winning goal.
Yeah, I mean, they had opportunities. They just never really got that knockout shot that could create it. I mean,
and now, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, please pay your attention to
just off the stick
right.
And not get it off.
Will the count
that's how
Washington County All Stars please skate forward
over
and claim your 2012-2013
MSC. We have an allegiance certainly to the North Stars without question. You more than I do for sure, but is this the best high school hockey game that you've seen?
Yes. Even though we didn't win, just the way that they came back,
and
the fact that it went deep into a sudden death overtime, I mean, it was a nail biter. I mean, last year we came in here and rolled right over Queen Anne's County, and it really wasn't much of a game. This one here, well, what can you say? It leaves you speechless.
Yeah, again, congratulations to Sigourney Park.
Oh, absolutely.
A heck of a team.
And
this was just two really good teams. If this was the best game of seven series, they would go seven games in an overtime. Yeah, it's really a shame that the North Stars don't get to play a team like this more often, and we know why. I mean, the North Stars, obviously, in the western region of the state, Sigourney Park in the eastern region, it's not one of those things that, from a travel standpoint, is one that you can make happen very easily. But, man, this was really a classic here tonight. You know, they talk about ESPN classics, how games are played, they wind up on air. You know, within the next day or two, this is one of those that will live in our memories for a long time.
Oh, yeah.
Unfortunately,
I'll never forget it.
Yeah, unfortunately, the North Stars don't get the W here, but, I mean, what a run for a team that had won back-to-back and had an opportunity here to make it three in a row. And I have a feeling, based on history, that the North Stars just aren't going away anytime soon.
Nope. They'll look different, but they'll be back.
Well, you get Josh Barron back, you get Travis Biggs back, you get
Omar,
Jeremy Benda back.
Omar Elmo Hendez.
Right, I mean, yeah, so many guys.
There will still be a core guys. Like I said, they'll look different. The younger guys on the team that, you know, they'll be a year older. You know, I was thinking Sigourney Park's Denko is a senior. I'm wondering, do they have one coming up through the ranks? I've seen that happen many times. That, you know, you ride that goalie for 4 years, but once he graduates, you got to have another one come in.
Yeah,
one thing the North Stars, since day one, have always had rock-solid goaltenders.
Yeah, there's no question about that. I mean, the only North Stars jersey that's ever been retired, the only number ever retired, belongs to their first-ever goalie. But, you know, I don't know what Sigourney Park has in the pipeline. They only have one goalie on their varsity roster, so I don't know what they might have in terms of a goalie on the front of the
team. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, the 2012-2013
very solid team.
Hockey League
North Stars
champion
took advantage
in the 1A division, Sigourney Park third period.
And Sigourney Park earned this one. The North Stars really made them earn it in the end. And again, just a great hockey game.